When the sins of my father weigh down in my soul, and the pain of my mother.
Yet among the mature we do impart wisdom, although it is not a wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age, who are doomed to pass away. But we impart a secret and hidden wisdom of God, which God decreed before the ages for our glorification. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the heart of man conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him, God has revealed to us through the Spirit, for the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what person knows a man's thoughts except the spirit of the man which is in him? So also no one comprehends the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is from God, that we might understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. And we impart this in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual truths to those who possess the Spirit.
May it rain.
Okay, everybody, this morning we're in 1 Corinthians again, or we'll be in there for a bit of time. We're going to run through it. I don't know if I'll talk about it every day, but it'll be a part of our daily lectionary cycle of readings for a bit. But today, Paul approaches the subject of wisdom, and he creates a dichotomy, or, you know, there's the wisdom of God, which is given, in which the world rejects, and then there's the wisdom of the world. So you kind of got to wonder, what does that mean? And when people often come to me or often bring up in discussions, you know, the world is sort of a straw man, if you will. Sometimes it's easy to say this is the wisdom of God, this is the wisdom of the world, God good, world bad. But when you live in it, what does it mean? You know, how do you go about your daily course of life in the world and not get, you know, infected or whatever by the wisdom of the world? What even is the wisdom of the world? And I think it's best shown, or a good jumping off point, is the incarnation of our Lord and Savior, or Christmas. Jesus, is born in a manger, extraordinarily vulnerable. He's not surrounded by armies and might and power, but he's born in a manger, surrounded by, you know, animals, shepherds, you know the story. And all he has to protect him is love, beauty, and grace. And that's what he has to protect himself from the world. And we see Herod invoking sort of the wisdom of the world, where Herod sends men out or decrees that every male under the age of 2 or whatever is to be destroyed, unalived, as the kids say nowadays. And so that's... you see there the wisdom of God, which understands that the only way to overcome the world is through love, beauty, grace. Then you have Herod, whose wisdom is to meet what he sees as a threat with a larger threat. You have Herod who destroys to protect himself. And so there you go. So I would, if someone asked me, I would sum up the wisdom of the world is the wisdom of the world. Kind of, we put ourselves in the place of God, and we see ourselves as the only means to achieve whatever we want, whether it's power, privilege, prominence, all those things, money, you know the drill. So all of those things, and then we meet threats, or wisdom of the world meets threats with a bigger threat, or meets violence with violence, or meets power with more power. And so the wisdom of the world, we try to best our enemies. We try to overcome adversaries. We force our way into where we want to be. And so we sort of take the place of God, or we put ourselves in the place of God. And not just with ourselves, but with other people, where we think, or we do our best to determine their fate. Meet a threat with a threat, with a larger threat. But the wisdom of God says no. You know, there is God, I am not God, and everyone has within them the image and likeness of God, and we have to go through the world with humility. We have to go through the world with love. We have to go through the world with grace. We have to go through the world with beauty. And so when you approach the world that way, instead of meeting another person seeing as a threat that you have to best, you go through the world when you meet another person, you know, you're seeing the image of God, and you interact with them with love, mercy, and grace, and beauty. And that seems wrong, I know, or it seems like it wouldn't work. But if we look again at the story of Christmas, what happens, right? Our salvation comes from that grace, love, beauty, mercy. So that's a little bit about the wisdom of God and the wisdom of the world. And so it does seem foolish to the world, because who would go into a situation with love, grace, mercy, and beauty instead of a huge hammer to destroy your opponent? But that's the wisdom of God. The wisdom of God meets everything with love, with mercy, with beauty, and with understanding. So where do you fall? Do you have more hammers in your bag to get through the day, or do you depend on love, beauty, mercy, forgiveness, grace? What do you navigate the world with? What is wisdom for you? Is wisdom a hammer, or is wisdom love? So there we go. That's our thought for the day. Everybody have a great day. Say your prayers. Love one another. Reach out to someone and tell them they're important. See you tomorrow. God bless you all. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.